Tantor Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents Plan and Organize Your Life. Achieve your goals by creating intentional habits and routines for success. By Beatrice Naujalyte. Narrated by Gina Rogers. Publisher's Note. In this audio edition, you will hear references to visual elements present in the print and ebook formats of the book. Foreword. I am honored to be writing the foreword for this book, and I am so excited for you to be taking this huge step toward a more organized and intentional life. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Cassandra Arson. I am the creator of Clutterbug, an organizing business that helps hundreds of thousands of families all over the world get organized. I am also the host of HGTV's Hot Mess House and author of 4 best-selling organizing books. I'm telling you this because I want you to know that just 10 short years ago, I was a stay-at-home mom drowning in clutter and living paycheck to paycheck. Every aspect of my life was a complete disaster. It wasn't until my late 30s that I finally discovered the power of planning, routines, and organization. When I began goal planning, organizing, and implementing easy routines, my entire life was transformed in a very short amount of time. Not only did my home look and function better, but I gained control of my finances, had more time and energy for friends and hobbies, and I was able to build an incredible business, all while being a mom to 3 children. Imagine if I had started at a younger age. That is why I am so excited for you to be listening to this book at this moment in your life. Beatrice is such an inspiration to so many through her blog and YouTube channel, and the most impressive part for me is that most of her followers are young adults. The fact that you are listening to this book means you already have a head start, and I want you to really let that sink in. In this book, you will learn life lessons that will impact every single area of your life in a positive way. Taking a dream and turning it into a plan is how magic is made, and this book will walk you through how to do that. I was always a big dreamer, but I didn't know how to take those dreams from wishing and hoping to doing and succeeding. Planning didn't come naturally to me, and honestly, I didn't take the time to learn until my life was completely falling apart. You are giving yourself such a gift by starting right now. If I had to pinpoint just one thing that made the biggest impact on my overall success, it was starting small and simple routines. Structure, discipline, and schedules are not my thing. I like to think I'm a free spirit, and I certainly don't want to be forced into any sort of box. I always thought that having routines would be stifling and strict. I assumed having daily and weekly routines would limit my freedom, when in fact, routines give my life so much more freedom. My routines are simple, but they gift me with more time, more energy, more focus, and much more happiness. I am able to achieve huge and seemingly impossible goals for myself because my daily routines keep me on track and keep me moving toward that bigger picture. So congratulations, I really mean that. This book is going to walk you through the easy and simple steps that you need to create that roadmap for your own life. Anything is possible. You just need to keep taking the right steps down your personal road toward success. This book has just given you a huge head start. Cassandra Arson, author of The Declutter Challenge and Cluttered Mess to Organized Success. Part 1, Introduction. Instead of finding time, make time. This is a mantra that has stuck with me for years. Perhaps it's not congruent with Einstein's theories about space-time. I'm a blogger, not a physicist. But it certainly is an inspiring reminder that with a little bit of effort and careful planning, you can create time, almost as if by magic, to do the things you love, spend time with the people you love, and design a life you love. I'll be honest with you. I haven't always been good at time management. Actually, I used to really, really suck at it, and procrastination was the name of my game. I firmly believed that a few extra minutes of sleep were worth rushing into school past the bell, and I treated due dates as due dates. In middle school, I would complain about homework taking up my entire evening, without realizing that maybe, just maybe, I would get it done faster if I didn't have my phone glued to my hand to text my friends every 2 minutes. So you see, I felt like I was working hard. I was stressed out, check. I had a packed schedule, check. I was exhausted and caught every single cold that went around the school because my immune system took the brunt of my poor self-care habits, check. Let's take stock of where I was at. I wanted to do well in school, but in reality, I was sinking all of my time into unproductive study habits and investing way too much time and energy into my grades. I wanted to spend more time with my family, but in reality, I always passed on doing fun things with them because I couldn't possibly imagine fitting them into my weekly schedule. I wanted to develop my hobbies, but I said yes to absolutely everything and used up all of my energy on an assortment of activities that hardly brought me joy. I was busy and outwardly successful, but frazzled and not all that productive. I decided that I needed to make a change. In high school, I began following different bloggers who shared tips on an organized life and started experimenting with my own planning and organization methods. I bought cute little agendas to write my weekly tasks in and even fashioned my own, far less cute, paper planner with scraps of plastic and hole-punched paper. The extent to which these experiments actually improved my productivity is debatable, but I took great pride in my color-coded creations. The summer before my junior year, however, I decided to take a different approach. Rather than categorizing my tasks by every imaginable attribute and spending hours designing planner layouts, I simply wanted to see where my time was going. Yeah, I knew I was busy, but busy doing what exactly? I downloaded a time-tracking app as an experiment and started tracking every minute of my day. My friends were a little confused when they saw my graphs and charts. Wait, how does this app know when you go to the bathroom? I entered all of that manually. Seeing exactly how I spent my time forced me to get honest with myself regarding my systems and commitments. Once I identified where I was sinking too much of my time and where I needed to invest more of it, I dove headfirst into the world of planning, productivity, and organization. I combed through articles and self-help books, deploying further experiments to test the different methods I learned about. Everything from the Pomodoro technique and Eisenhower matrices to time blocking and eating the frog. We'll get to that later. As I picked up my favorite techniques and began to implement them, every area of my life started to improve. I was able to get things done faster, maintain good grades with far less effort, relax and recharge with family and friends, and start the Bliss Bean in 2017. Design a life you love. The story of the Bliss Bean. With this new passion for personal development, I suddenly started looking at every area of my life through a lens of improvement and optimization. I wanted to understand not only how to be more productive, but more specifically, how to work more efficiently on the right things in order to design a life I loved. Of course, I won't claim that my entire life changed the moment I cracked open a self-improvement book and I suddenly had it all figured out. Just like any high school student, I was still lacking sleep and balancing an uncomfortable number of plates. However, I felt on top of things in a way I'd never felt before, and I was genuinely excited to keep learning more. That difference was immeasurable. In July 2017, I finally decided to start the blog I had always dreamed of. I had dabbled in craft blogs as a kid, but now I wanted to share what I was learning about. I started to carve out time during evenings and weekends to create content about personal development, productivity, and mindfulness. It was almost like an online journal. It documented my growth and evolved with my interests, and the audience I grew became something like a family. It only made sense that they would be a part of this book. Meet the Bliss Bean readers and viewers who contributed their personal planning and organization tips to every section of this book. Look out for blurbs from them. Alice Preece is a final-year university student in Sheffield, England. She studies journalism and loves nothing more than meticulously planning out her life each week, except for maybe binging BTS YouTube videos. Ana Mora is a literature student in Chile. She uses her bullet journal to plan out her schoolwork, reading assignments, and events to make sure everything is finished before the due date. Antonia Sarafova is from Bulgaria and is currently studying creative business at BUAS in the Netherlands while growing her brand as a micro-influencer. Carlotta Urban is a high school student from Germany who uses her planning systems to manage schoolwork and many creative hobbies like a poetry Instagram account and theater classes. Caroline Theuerkoff is a junior triple majoring in political science, international and comparative studies, and German at a university in the U.S. She uses a combination of digital and paper planning systems to organize her schoolwork, extracurriculars, and volunteer work. Cristina Barrancos lives in Portugal and teaches Portuguese to English-speaking students. She uses a variety of paper and digital tools to book lessons, schedule her day, and manage tasks. Joy Shim is a PhD candidate studying philosophy in the United States. Although she loves pens and paper, she has seen the digital light and can never go back. Katie Rennick is a listing specialist for a local property management company in Florida. She's an iPad fanatic and uses GoodNotes and Pinterest to design the aesthetic of her work and life. Kirti is a gap year student in India who spent her gap year waking up early to self-study topics like particle physics, digital art, and quantum computing. She believes productivity is more about learning and having fun than getting things done. Kimberly Holmeyer is an 11th grade student in Germany. She uses her bullet journal to plan out her schoolwork and personal to-dos for each day. Kyla Bertrand is a culinary arts management student in London. She uses a paper planner to list her top three priorities each day. Mariah is a freshman in college from Montana, USA, studying molecular and cellular biology. She loves to sing, dance, and make schedules to her heart's content. Mawada Tariq is an artist and a German language teacher from Sudan studying electrical engineering. She enjoys art and uses a bullet journal, Notion, and a DIY scheduling board for her planning. Max Gonzalez Garcia is finishing a psychology degree in Spain and plans on going to music school afterwards. He uses a mix of paper and digital tools to juggle tasks like music practice and homework. Sahana Hariharan is an Indian 11th grade student who likes to go with the flow when it comes to her planning systems, whether that means making to-do lists on sticky notes or tracking habits in Notion. Sandra Patricia Ruelas Lisboa is a college freshman studying marketing in Puerto Rico and a list maker since the age of 7. She loves art and posts content to her blog and YouTube channel. Shivani Shah is a dental student studying in the UK. She curates an intentional life so she can focus more time on the essential. Currently, that consists of building good habits and sharing meaningful content on her YouTube channel, Dental Shiv. Shruti Bhaskar is a textile design student from India and has been using the bullet journal for 3 to 4 years. She uses a combination of Notion and bullet journaling to manage her academic goals and personal habits. Trivia Luthra is a high school freshman in India and uses a bullet journal to organize her life, including endless school assignments and interests like language learning. Zuzana Czopik is a Polish communications and media student at a British university. She prefers planning on paper, using mind maps, and a bullet journal to break down her academic and social media management side hustle projects into bite-sized tasks. Today, I'm grateful for every part of my personal development journey. If I had not started in a place of procrastination and constant stress, I wouldn't have looked for something better and stumbled upon this passion of mine. I've gotten the grades I wanted, started my own photography business, gotten into my dream college, and grown the Bliss Bean into my full-time dream job, garnering over 10 million views on YouTube, and now writing this book. Why plan? I know. All of this planning and organization can seem like way too much work for some faint future benefits. I promise you, though, it is worth it. Here are a few reasons why. 1. It feels really good to get things done. You know that feeling when you finish a big project? When you get some annoying to-do off your shoulders? Or when you finish a long day of crossing off important tasks? By optimizing the way you work, you'll experience that feeling of accomplishment much more often. Hopefully, every single day. 2. You'll feel more confident. Setting goals and putting in consistent work toward them over the long run builds your trust in yourself and creates a deep-seated sense of confidence. You'll realize that you're capable of so much more than you thought. 3. You'll have more free time. The goal of these planning techniques is not to simply fit more work into the day, but rather to spend more time on what matters most. You'll be able to schedule time with friends and family, block out time for relaxation, and develop your side hustles and passion projects. 4. Your someday will become a reality. While you may be getting by without any sort of planning and organization system and completing your most urgent tasks right at the buzzer without missing any deadlines, chances are you have a list in your head of things you would like to do someday that your frantic, last-minute schedule leaves no time for. Imagine if you could actually achieve those bucket list goals. 5. You'll understand yourself better. Having a system for capturing, taking action on, and reviewing your thoughts, dreams, and ideas is a big step toward developing a healthy relationship with yourself. Make a bucket list of those someday things that you'll be able to do once you have a good planning and organization system in place. Where to start? Before we dive into designing the perfect planning and organization system for you, let's start with doing an audit of your current systems. Aspiring organizers often spread themselves out among a jumble of different tools that catch their eye. So let's assess where all of your to-dos, notes, and ideas currently live. Make a list of all the tools you currently use to organize and/or plan your life. Mobile apps, web apps, notebooks, bullet journals, paper planners and calendars, digital calendars, post-it notes, random napkins, the back of your hand, anything. As you design your new planning and organizing system, make sure you transfer over any important information. Our goal throughout this process is to simplify. That doesn't mean that you need to find the one magical tool that will solve everything. If you've been able to do that, please share your secret with me. What it does mean, however, is that you will achieve a state of organized bliss through the minimum number of different tools that you need. I've compiled a list of resources, including budgeting spreadsheets and time tracking categories, both of which we'll get into a bit later, to help you achieve your personal organization goals. You can find these examples and more at theblissbean.com/book resources. Just like an organized home requires that every item has a designated place, an organized life requires that every piece of information has its place as well. With an organized system, you always know exactly where your notes, appointments, plans, and ideas are. The less you're keeping track of and juggling in your mind, the more room there is to achieve clarity and for true creativity to flow. In an organized system, every piece of information has a designated place. the four pillars of planning and organization that we'll cover in this book. Planning. We will first put into place a system to track all of your to-dos in life and learn how to implement regular yearly, monthly, weekly, and daily planning routines to ensure that nothing slips through the cracks. Organization. Then, we'll move on to organizing your tools and thoughts, your physical workspace, your digital files, your phone, etc., and your system for capturing ideas and notes. Productivity. No Bliss Bean book would be complete without a discussion of productivity techniques. Don't worry, you don't have to implement them all. We'll talk about tried and tested techniques that you can pick and choose to design your own productivity toolbox. Habits and routines. Finally, we'll close out the book by designing some habits and routines to keep you moving forward and growing. After all, your dream life is created not in one sitting, but through small daily actions. Let's begin. Part 2. Planning. Chapter 1. Assembling Your Planning Toolbox. If you're searching this book for advice because you're just not good at planning, stop right there. Planning is just like creativity, which many people also claim to be not good at. While some are born with a predisposition for organizing, it is a skill and muscle that anyone can build through simple practice. The habits and mindsets of planning proactively may not come naturally to you now, but trust that through implementing these techniques and witnessing firsthand how much more intentional and fulfilling your life can be, you can become one of those planner people too. If you currently have no planning system to speak of, the first thing you'll need to do is build the daily habit of checking in with your plans. Try to pair it with one of your existing habits so that an action that is already automatic to you triggers the new one you are trying to develop. Do you drink coffee at the kitchen table every morning? Leave your planner there and look over your plan for the day as you caffeinate. Do you spend time scrolling through your phone before you go to sleep? Leave your planner on the bedside table and take a moment to review the day before you pick up your phone. Just a few minutes of focus each day is all you need. Calendars. Before we get into the big picture of turning your dreams into daily actions, let's look at how you manage the day-to-day of your busy life. A calendar is an essential tool to keep track of your commitments, remember important dates, and understand how you're using your time. You'll first need to choose whether a digital calendar or an analog one suits you best. Digital. Positives. It syncs across all of your devices. It can notify you of upcoming events automatically. It allows for easy shuffling and rearranging of your schedule. It has room for lots of extra event information, such as address, invitees, web links, notes, etc. It can repeat events automatically, so you never have to think about rescheduling. Digital negatives. A calendar that lives in the cloud can be easy to forget about, out of sight, out of mind. You can't create an event if you don't have your phone or computer with you. There are possible privacy concerns. Paper positives. Physically writing down your commitments can help you remember them better. A paper calendar never needs to be recharged. It can be highly visible if displayed on your desk or on the wall. Paper negatives. It can be misplaced, thus losing all of your important information. You may not have it with you when you need to check it to schedule an event. It can get messy if you need to edit it often. It's harder to visualize how much of your day an event actually takes up without a timeline view. It can't be synced with other people's calendars. If you want to combine the benefits of both methods, you could use a hybrid system. For example, you could keep a master calendar in a digital format, then take a few minutes every Monday morning to write your weekly events and appointments on a highly visible whiteboard in your office. Or you could use a digital calendar, with all of its scheduling and syncing capabilities, for work, and a good old-fashioned paper calendar for your personal life. Tools for calendars. iCal. Free. It comes pre-installed on Apple devices, so if you already have an iPhone and/or Mac, picking something that's part of the digital ecosystem you already use makes things easier. On the other hand, if you use Android or Windows devices, you're out of luck. iCal allows you to color-code events, add additional information, set alerts and repeating schedules, and add invitees via email. You can sync it with Google Calendar, but collaborating across different platforms can get a little tricky, so you might want to take into account what your coworkers and family use if you need to share events with them. Google Calendar. Free. A popular calendar that works well with the Google ecosystem, Gmail, Google Drive, Google Meet, etc., and is available on pretty much any digital device you might use. As with most calendar tools, you can create multiple calendars, share them with other people, customize alerts, schedule repeating events, add attachments, invite guests, etc. Personally, I prefer the design of iCal, but needed some of the collaborative features of Google Calendar, so I signed into my Google account through iCal to sync the two. Microsoft Outlook. Free. Upgraded plans available. This calendar tool integrates with the Microsoft Office apps, like Outlook Email, and is often used by large organizations. Fantastical. Paid. This app is practically a cult favorite. It offers tons of features to make scheduling quick, like natural language entry. You can simply type in dentist appointment, October 13th, 10 a.m., alert, 45 minutes, to create an event, and various views to visualize your schedule in different ways. Notion. Free. Upgraded plans available. The productivity tool has a calendar view to visualize items in a database based on the dates attached to them. This might be helpful if you already use Notion, but it's not built to be an all-purpose calendar tool. Scheduling repeating events is currently not possible, and it doesn't integrate well with other calendars, emails, or scheduling tools like Calendly. There are probably more calendar tools out there than you could ever try. Keep in mind that you don't need all the fancy bells and whistles. Pick what gets the job done for you. Zuzana, a communication and media university student in England, usually prefers using paper tools like her bullet journal for planning, but makes an exception for digital calendars. Rather than a list of events, she prefers a timeline view with blocked out appointments to visualize how much free time she actually has. As your life changes, so will the tools you use. Alice used to live and die by her Apple Calendar because it synced easily across her Apple Watch, iPhone, and Mac, and made it easy to add events on the go. However, while working and studying from home during the pandemic lockdown, she switched to a simpler paper calendar to plan out appointments, lectures, meetings, and self-care activities, like calling friends or going for walks. How to organize your calendar. Separating your events based on category can help you stay organized with a busy schedule. If you use a digital calendar, you can create separate calendars that you can then hide individually from view or share with relevant people. With a paper calendar, you might keep a separate calendar in your kitchen for personal events and one at your office for work appointments. Or you may use different colors of pens and highlighters to color-code events on the same calendar. As an example, the categories I personally have for my calendar are personal, blog/work, exercise classes, and birthdays. Separating calendars might make it easier for you to organize different areas of your life. However, Alice prefers to plan her lectures and meetings all together in one calendar because when it's separated, she warns, you can accidentally hide a calendar and forget that something is happening. If you're someone who needs to schedule a lot of meetings with other people, follow these tips for efficient scheduling and fewer back and forth email chains. Share your entire work calendar with a loved one or colleague with whom you work closely. They'll be able to see your schedule and plan around it without needing to ask you. Use a tool like Calendly to make it easy for others to book slots on your calendar. Calendly syncs with your personal calendars and has oodles of features like automatic reminder emails, daily limits on the number of meetings, and the ability to schedule meetings with multiple people at the same time. I use this all the time whenever I need to schedule a podcast interview or a check-in call. Use a tool like Doodle to coordinate schedules with a group of people, whether for a team meeting or a movie night with friends. Anyone who's invited to the poll can select the times that work for them. Eliminate the need for back-and-forth emails by investing a bit of time upfront to write a good email that achieves the end goal. Cal Newport calls this process-centric email in his book, Deep Work. For example, if someone wants to schedule a meeting with you, do the work upfront to get as many of the details sorted out right away as you can. Here's an example email. I would love to look over your graphic design portfolio with you. Please send me what you have so far and your updated LinkedIn page, and I'll put together some feedback. I'm available Tuesday from 3:30 to 4:30 p.m., Wednesday from 10 to 11 a.m., and Friday at 12 to 1 p.m. If any of those times work for you, let me know, and we'll consider the meeting set. If none of those times work for you, you can contact me at, insert your phone number, anytime after 5 p.m., and we can find a different time. I'll send you a Zoom invite. Christina teaches Portuguese to English speakers and uses Calendly to book lessons with students, which then show up on her Google Calendar. To make sure she has time off to recharge and do her other work, she has set up restrictions on Calendly so that lessons cannot be booked on Thursdays or Sundays. Later, we'll talk more about how to use your calendar for time blocking and long-term goal planning, but let's pause here for the moment. If you're currently scattered between calendar tools, 1. Pick your favorite tool or tools to transfer all of your commitments into. 2. Choose categories for your events if it helps to keep things separate. For example, work, personal, meetings, school, holidays, family, exercise, etc. 3. Share relevant calendars with anyone who might need access to them. 4. Schedule repeating events for those things that happen on a regular basis. 5. Make sure, if you're using a digital tool, that you have access to this calendar on all of your devices. Task management. Not everything goes on your calendar. There are also those seemingly endless lists of to-dos that we need to take care of at an unspecified time. We'll talk later about how to minimize your to-dos and break your goals down into tiny steps. But for the time being, let's talk about different ways to track these action items. Digital. Positives. You can sync your tasks across devices. You can schedule repeating tasks, for example, weekly chores or a monthly report. You can add extra information to tasks like files, links, collaborators, due dates, reminders, priority level, etc. Digital negatives. Digital devices can be a distraction when you need to focus on deep work. It can be easy to forget about your tasks when they live somewhere in the cloud. Paper positives. It keeps things simple. Extra information can become distracting clutter. It allows total freedom to draw, diagram, and sketch however you see fit. It can be used in environments where electronic devices are not allowed, for example, during class. It can be a more tangible and focused experience than punching keys and staring at a screen. Paper negatives. It can be misplaced. You would lose some very important information. It gets messy when you need to erase, rewrite, and reschedule a lot. Different planning tools. Store-bought planners. Pre-made paper planners usually contain monthly calendars and templates for your daily planning and scheduling. These require little setup on your part, come in various designs, and you can look for a format that includes the features you're looking for. Specialty planners. These are pre-made paper planners that offer more guidance, like templates for weekly and monthly reviews, goal planning, and journaling. They often have loyal users and strong communities behind them that can give you advice and support. For example, Passion Planner, Panda Planner, Erin Condren Life Planner, Happiness Planner. Bullet Journals. This is a DIY system designed by Ryder Carroll that combines your calendar, tasks, and journaling into a standardized system that allows lots of room for customization. While it's often done in creative and beautiful ways, the basic system requires nothing more than a notebook and a pen. Comprehensive task management tools. These are digital apps that help you to manage complicated projects and tasks. Any feature you are looking for, like assigning tasks to other people and attaching due dates, labels, contexts, etc., can probably be found. Keep in mind that not everyone needs all of these features. However, if you're managing a lot of projects and little tasks simultaneously, a comprehensive program can help you keep track of it all. For example, Things 3, OmniFocus, Todoist. Simple digital tools. If you want the convenience of digital without all of the bells and whistles, a simple to-do list or checklist app might do the trick. Google users can try Google Keep, Apple Notes is a solid option for iOS, and there are plenty of other apps out there that promise minimal features, like To-Do and Minimalist. A big draw of paper planning is that it's totally analog. There are no distracting bells and whistles, no pinging notifications to flood your brain with information. If you prefer to plan digitally, give yourself that same opportunity to shut off all distractions. Close unnecessary tabs on your computer, turn off notifications, and keep your screen nice and minimal. Just like with your calendar, you don't have to go all in on one system. For example, you can use a powerful digital task manager to hold all of your tasks and then write your daily tasks on a piece of paper to minimize distractions and overwhelm. At the end of the day, you can refer back to the task manager to update what you got done and plan the next day's to-do list. There's a lot of power in analog simplicity. In fact, there was a popular Kickstarter campaign that raised $450,000 for a wooden stand that holds a paper card with your daily to-dos. Once in a while, a trendy tool surfaces on YouTube, and it seems like every last person on the internet throws away their previous systems to hop on the bandwagon. Remember, just because there's a lot of chatter online about a tool doesn't necessarily mean it'll be a good fit for you. Feel free to give it a try, but if it doesn't work for your lifestyle, that's...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.